over. Holy grail.
I don't dance now, I make money move.
Ladies and gentlemen.
I don't gotta dance, I make money move.
Boring Party presents Bobby's Top X.
What's going on, guys? It is Bobby. I'm your host of Bobby's Top X. And you might be wondering who this exquisitely handsome man is sitting next to me. And it's a treat. It's a two-for-one Bobby.
Right, two Bobbies.
two Bobbies for one. This is Chef Bobby. He is the owner of St. Louis Wing Company in St. Louis, Missouri. And you do awesome stuff.
Thank you, man.
I love everything you've ever done. I see you on the local news. I see you everywhere, man. And when I decided to do an episode about best wing flavors, there was only one place I could think of. And that was this place right here, St. Louis Wing Company. We're here at 9816 Manchester Road.
Yep.
You guys can come here virtually any day of the week.
Yeah, we're open 7 days a week.
7 days a week till
in the morning. And we close at 9 p.m. And then Fridays and Saturdays we close at 10.
Yeah. You guys can get it all the time. You can order online. You can go to their website, stlwingco.com. They're on Facebook. Everything, man. I don't know if you guys can see this plethora. So this is how you know you've got a good wing place, is when they have this thing here that doesn't come off the table. This is what happens right here. You put your paper towels because you're gonna get messy when you eat your wings, so you know it's a good wing place. But if you guys can see all this, this is what Bobby and I are gonna tackle today. This is the top five chicken wing flavors.
Before we get into the wings, I do wanna give everybody a little bit of backstory. So you are a classically trained chef.
And what made you go from making beautiful dinners to fine dining to chicken wings? But these are beautiful as well.
Yeah, I mean, you know, so, okay. Well, my entire career I've been classically trained. I've worked in fine dining restaurants my whole career. I mean, for almost 20 years. That was really fun for me. I really enjoy playing with different foods, seafoods, you know, all kinds of stuff. I really enjoy that. That's what my life is, you know, food. But I wanted to open a restaurant that had like more longevity.
Right.
So a lot of the nicer restaurants, they don't last for longer than 5 years. You know, I'll say.
Right.
So
right.
If they do, they're lucky.
Yeah.
You know what I mean, like Cafe Napoli. And Clayton's been there for over 20 years. They don't even advertise, you know.
I don't think I've ever seen an advertising form.
No, you won't. And they're packed every night.
Yeah.
You know, so I mean, they're lucky. He's lucky. You know, certain restaurants that have that longevity, they're lucky. So what I wanted to do, I was wanting to create a concept where it would stick around. It would be timeless. You know, like it would only grow with time. You know, because when a fine dining restaurant comes out, there's a lot of hype and everybody wants to go check it out, and you know, they're on the news, they're in the newspapers,
right? Right.
And then after a year it's like, okay, it kind of like dies.
It kind of lulls off. Yeah.
And then after 3 years they're like putting Groupons out there trying to get people to come in. It's like,
yeah,
you know. So I really like the concept of chicken wings with different flavors, like Wingstop. And I wasn't a big fan of Wingstop's food, no offense, but personally I was like, I want to add my personal touch, no preservatives, everything from scratch. So that's kind of how it was born. I went into a wing restaurant, I liked the concept, but I wasn't too excited about their food. So I said, you know, I'm going to do my own and use my training, my classical training, and all of my knowledge about menu production and all that stuff, and apply that to chicken. I mean, you could put anything on chicken.
You know, I always wanted to open a chicken restaurant, but I didn't want to call it like something conventional. I wanted to just call it Bok Bok.
That would have been cool.
Like,
you still can.
I think it would have been an awesome name, and do like everything to do with chicken, grilled chicken, you know, chicken patties, all that stuff.
Dude.
And have different flavors like this, like a peanut butter and jelly.
Did it?
Okay. I always thought it would be kind of a cool little combination, that chicken with the sweet and the...
Maybe my version just kind of failed, because it was quick and I was like over it. Yeah, we don't have to talk about that. But you should do that, man. That would be a cool...
I thought it would be an awesome idea. I tried to do a food truck. I had a food truck. I was trying to get a food truck. It was going really well, but I mean, you have to have investors and people to help you instead of borrowing from your own paycheck.
There's a lot of stuff that goes into it.
So
a lot of permits and all that crazy. I mean, dude, there's so much. There's so many rules that you have to follow.
Yeah. It's and like, you have to, the one city is different than the county, and then the other county is different, and it makes it where it's difficult because something that's legal in the county is not legal in the city, and something that's legal in the city is not legal in that third county, and it makes it where it's difficult. So we're going to get into the wings. We're gonna pause for a second so that you can see all these awesome wings getting made, and then we're going to get into the wings. So hang on for a second. Check this out. We're back. I hope you enjoyed seeing all of that. It makes me hungry watching all of that. So we're going to dive into the wings. So, Chef, this is our number five wing. What would you say your number five wing is?
Man, you know, when you asked me to do that, I had the most difficult time trying to come up with my most popular in the order. And I will say that our most popular wing is the traditional buffalo wing.
Okay.
Which I didn't bring out here.
Good.
Because it's boring. I mean, it's not boring. It's just...
But everybody can try traditional. I mean, unfortunately, you can go anywhere. You have your own spin on it, but anybody can go get a buffalo chicken
these
wing.
These flavors here, I guarantee you can't get anywhere else in St. Louis.
Good.
I promise you that. So, if I were to sit down to a meal full of chicken wings, this would be what I would eat.
And so. This is exactly what I would want.
Number five. So, right here we've got the marinara with shaved parmesan. And we make our marinara from scratch. Like, we get celery, onions,
really?
We puree that.
You won't find that at another wing place at all. They're not going to invest their time in something that's not chicken.
Like, our marinara sauce is made from scratch with fresh ingredients.
That's amazing.
We cook it for 2 hours.
Wow.
Yeah, we do that about 3 times a week.
Wow. I mean, if you're doing that 3 times a week, you're going through.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, we make 2 gallons every time we make it. So we go through 6 gallons of marinara sauce a week, which
isn't
that much. I mean, when you think about it.
But for this, it is.
Yeah. So it goes with our toasted raviolis and our mozzarella sticks. So there's no way that I was going to have a marinara sauce on my menu that came out of a can.
Good. Especially someone like you, a trained chef. Well, let's try these first.
Chicken parmesan is like, that's what it is.
So these are chicken parmesan. Grab one of these. I'm a big drummy dude.
I'm a fat.
Really? It seems like too much work. That's the only reason why I like this.
You take the bone.
And you twist and you pull.
You pull that off.
Oh, yeah, and then you got it all right there.
That's easier.
Oh. That sauce is definitely...
It tastes of freshness.
Oh, man. I'm only supposed to eat one bite, but it's okay.
All right.
And see, this is why you got the towel rack.
So the next one, I guess, the Thai sweet chili.
Okay.
This is, you may find this in other places, but we definitely tweaked the recipe on our own. How you doing? So everything is made from scratch. We add stuff to it.
To make it yours.
Yeah, there's a peanut in there. There's,
really?
There's vinegar. There's sambal, the Vietnamese chili paste is in here. This is one of our most popular wings.
So, besides doing my amazing show, I deal cards at the casino. I deal with a lot of Asian people.
Oh, yeah.
This, Asian people would die for.
They do.
Oh, man.
The ladies from the nail shop come down here all the time.
Really?
We'll add some habanero puree.
It's got good flavor, and it's not like when you say, you know, peanut sauce and stuff like that, you don't really, it's not overpowered. So it's really, really good. Love that flavor.
These are the Red Hot River.
And if you see, there's actual Red Hots in this, and those are my absolute favorite. And I love this because it's a St. Louis thing.
Yes, so how those were born, somebody sent me a message on Facebook saying, with a picture of some Flamin' Hot Cheeto wings. And when they told me, you know, you should try this, and I said, well, I'm from St. Louis and I love my city. I'll be right with you. I'm sorry.
Really?
Yeah, give me, I'll be right with you. So how this was born is when somebody sent me the picture of some Flamin' Hot Cheeto wings, and I wasn't a fan. I thought about it, and I was like, you know, that might be cool, but to actually serve hundreds of them a day would get really expensive. It would be a pain in the butt. So, and plus, I'm really about my city, so Red Hot Riblets, I grew up on. I mean, I grew up eating these chips. So, I'm like, how can I make a Red Hot Riblet wing? And a lot of people think that I take the chips and I grind them up in a food processor, but I don't do that. I actually got with my knowledge of chefism, you know, my culinary knowledge,
right,
got a bunch of different seasonings together, paprika, hickory seasoning, salt, garlic, cayenne pepper, and I just started adding stuff.
But you made your own. You didn't get, you know, because they have it at the store now.
Yeah.
They have the seasoning. You made your Red Hot Riblet seasoning.
I made my own Red Hot Riblet seasoning before they started making theirs.
Right.
I gave them the idea to put theirs in a bottle.
Really?
Yeah. And so, which is cool. You know, there's enough love to go around, but I originated this, and I inspired them to make that seasoning into a bottle. So, basically, I just tasted the chip, tasted the seasoning, tasted the chip until I got
the until flavor. It got to the same, yeah.
And it was the rest is history, man. So these are
excited for this.
These got really, really popular.
And they're crispy, and from the heat of the wing, it almost caramelizes all that rub.
It's really great.
Oh,
if you love the chip, you're gonna love the heat.
Mm-hmm. Exactly like the chip. Exactly like the chip. I would be, for sure. That's exactly like the chip. Man, it's crazy how perfect that is.
Man, people come here and get 50, 100 of these and take them to their family occasions. Like, I would say that we were really popular and St. Louis knew about us, but I would say that the Red Hot Riblet, when they went viral on Facebook, it just catapulted us into another.
So I'm going to New York in 2 weeks. I would take those to New York to show people.
Yeah.
Because those are that good.
It's cool.
Love that. That's the best one I like so far. The marinara is great, but I never thought you could replicate that.
Number two. All right, these are the Cajun Alfredo. This is like a Cajun. It's a creamy Cajun sauce with Parmesan cheese and garlic and some Cajun seasonings, cayenne pepper, paprika, chili powder.
I had a feeling it was some sort of Alfredo because while I was watching you make this, it looked like a white sauce.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh man, that's weird. What is he making with a white sauce?
And then we had crumbled turkey bacon and Parmesan cheese.
Turkey bacon.
Because we get a lot of non-pork here.
Yeah.
Yeah. So just to please everybody.
Oh. My doctor is not going to be happy that I didn't start the diet today. Don't watch this video. I could eat 50 of those. For sure.
At this point, I don't do this very often to sit down.
And enjoy your own.
I really don't.
All right, let's get into these last ones. These look amazing. I like the drizzle over the top. They're aesthetically pleasing.
They are, man. These are pretty sexy wings. These are the Mardi Gras wings.
Okay.
So I made these for Mardi Gras last year, and it's our zesty dry rub wing with a drizzle of a Creole remoulade, which is a spicy mayo.
Yeah.
That goes on like crab cakes and po' boys in Louisiana.
Uh-huh.
So I drizzled the remoulade and then green onions, and I had purple cabbage on there, but it just became too much to keep up with.
Sure.
It didn't really taste like anything, so.
But it was the color and stuff.
Yeah,
I get it.
Cool. And these are actually my favorite wings.
Are they?
Yeah. Because I love the remoulade.
Mm-hmm.
It's got that spiciness to it.
But it's got that creamy flavor to it as well.
Yeah.
And then the dry rub makes it really good too.
You know, I say this is my favorite because it's one of the newest. You know, because like every time I come up with something new, I'm like, that's my new favorite.
And in the wing business, they also, like we said, they have the fries, and it's called Freak Your Fries.
Freak My Fries.
You can get here at Wing Co. You can check out all this stuff as well as other flavors besides the five that we had, the fries that we had. Yeah, that's what I was doing while you were taking care of business. I ate like three more of those Red Hot Ripple ones. You can check out all this stuff though at stlwingco.com. You'll find them on Twitter at stlwingco, Instagram, Facebook. They're all there. There's a phone number right there, 314-962-WING. You can call, place an order. I mean, they're everywhere, man. And if you don't see them, tell the people that you know that you want these guys there, because these are the best wings in St. Louis. In my opinion, the best wings in the country. I lived in Baltimore for a year. I had chicken wings there, and they didn't taste anything like this. I'm going to eat another Alfredo as we get ready to go. Good, man. And I like seeing the different flavors and the combinations and stuff. I like seeing you on the news. I like seeing good people be successful. And that's one thing that worries me about St. Louis is there's not enough good people trying to help other good people. And that's why I wanted to make sure I showcase you guys, because you're good people. And I know that good things are going to happen here besides the good things that have already happened.
I appreciate that, man.
So, bon appetit. Make sure you guys check it out, STL Wing Co. Anything else you want
to?
I'm going to just eat a wing while you close it out.
I might just eat some more wings, too. Check out our social medias and, you know, drop some comments if you've already been here before. That'd be cool. Check us out, man. We're going.
Tell them you saw us on. Tell them you saw Bobby on the show.
Yeah. If you're watching this, let us know at the counter that you saw us on the show and heard about us through that, because we'd really like to know.
Absolutely, man.
Yeah. I'm gonna say thanks.
We're starting out. We're growing. You know, this show's gonna get bigger, and it's because you guys are gonna get bigger because of it. Or maybe we're going to get bigger because of you.
Or maybe the other way
around. Or I don't know, something.
Yeah, man, I appreciate it.
Absolutely. Make sure you guys check it out, stlwingco.com, stlwingco on all your social media. Bon appetit. See you, brother.